Today we have the privilege of hosting the one and only Ramy Ibrahim, Senior Mortgage Manager at TD Bank with around 30 years of experience. Join us as we dive into the mortgage market today. Ramy, thank you for being with us today. Given the market condition and uncertainty in the mortgage rates, what advice would you have for our buyers or sellers in today's market for the next coming months?
Thanks for having me today, Marco. Really appreciate the opportunity. I guess in answer to your question, there's a few factors. In the next coming months, we're still going to see some volatility with respect to interest rates. And as interest rates move, the affordability or the stress testing also changes as well. More importantly, I think for the buyers, ultimately a lot of buyers, there have been many buyers the last few years, and they're under that notion that things are the same as what they were, 24 months ago. So I would always encourage the buyers to update their pre-approval, or any of the clients that you're showing properties to update their pre-approvals, which is very, very key. Getting a complete, thorough, a credit investigation, of these clients' income, their down payment, is it a primary residence, is it a rental buyer, like you mentioned, is it an investor? Every pre-approval is going to be different depending on that type of, investor or buyer client. But more importantly, just be prepared, because at this point, that preparation, will constantly change in terms of market volatility. As rates go up, the qualification, goes up as well. Utilities go up, whether it's the property taxes or the condo fees and so forth. All these aspects you have to analyze when you're pre-approving somebody. But not necessarily everybody needs a mortgage as well, right? There are a lot of cash buyers in the market. There are a lot of people that take low balance mortgages. So I think just preparation and budgeting is key. It's more important than ever. Because if you're not up to date on being pre-approved, you might be relying on older pre-approval that has changed, and it could have changed dramatically just because of the qualification and stress test changes, basically.
Amazing. So Ramy, let's say for a home price of $1.2 million, how the qualification has changed over the course of 2 years compared to today. We'd like to know how the mortgage rate will change, how the qualification will change, and how does that affect our home buyers?
Good question, Marco. I think the affordability based on today and looking at 18 to 24 months ago, to no surprise, because of the stress test rule getting a little bit more challenging, it's reduced affordability by about 20%. Stress test, or that affordability test, has really gone up about it's about 8% today. Why I say 8%, how we qualify borrowers today, it's based on your current, your actual contractual rate plus a rate of 2%. So for example, if you're taking out a 5-year mortgage, let's just use an example of 6%, we have to add 2% to it. So that has now become 8% compared to historically, we're using 5.25% over the years. So on that $1.2 million mortgage, and again, we're assuming that that buyer is putting 20% down. Not all buyers are requiring 20% down, Marco,
for
a purchase price. My average mortgage historically over the last few years has usually been about $500,000 to $600,000. But if you want to use an example of a 20% down payment on a purchase price of $1.2 million, that mortgage amount is about $960,000. So historically, when the rates or the qualifying rate was lower, that payment at around 5.25%, we had to qualify individuals for a monthly payment of around $5,300 a month, assuming that they were going to borrow $960,000. Okay. Now that that contractual rate has increased, to the example that I gave you earlier, which is in and around an 8% range, that dollar amount that we need to qualify individuals at has gone up to about $6,900. So it's about a 20% difference. But if you look at it that way, it's either 20% down, up or down in terms of borrowing power. So when I say, you know, up or down, meaning that, again, we're assuming that, you know, we don't really know what that other individual's debts are.
Of course.
Do they have a car lease? Do they have major credit cards? You know, what their mortgage size is. But, you know, if they don't have any debts and they're borrowing $960,000, which again is very rare these days, it does make a difference for sure. And I think a big win to sort of combat that affordability based on today's elevated rate environment compared to 18 to 24 months ago is, you know, cut down your unsecured debt, or, you know, look at your budget to see how you can, you know, make things work. Marco, with respect to what I hear in the media and some clients that I actually help out on a day-to-day basis, you hear, you know, media portrays slowdown, or some of the consumers say slowdown in the real estate market. And I feel sometimes the media looks at this across the country. Can you just narrow down the GTA market and explain what does slowdown mean to you, basically?
Amazing question. So when we're talking about the slowdown in the market, we got to know which angle we're looking at. To answer short, I have to tell you the number of transactions has significantly dropped compared to height of the market. However, the prices has not dropped much. In some neighborhoods, we're actually seeing moderate increase in the prices. Obviously, in some neighborhoods, we see dropped in the price, but not much. So to answer your question, the number of transactions dropped, prices not much, and the reason being is because we don't have enough inventories out there.